I'm so sorry.
Sit there for hours beats me.
Hey, sweetie.
Come on, you've got to get out of that chair and get some fresh air.
Honestly, I'm fine.
No, you're not. Come on. Here sometime to write. It's so much more inspiring than that desk.
Look, a writer writes where a writer wants to write.
Is that another one of your famous quotes again?
It's true though. I mean, some people like confined spaces, some people like openness. Everybody's differently, just respect that.
Okay, don't get worked up about it. It was just a suggestion. So, how's the book going anyway?
I don't know, it's alright. I mean, I have trouble writing the climactic points, you know? It's just, I guess I get there in the end.
So, can you tell me about it yet?
Yeah, I guess. It's a drama about a middle-aged couple struggling to live abroad.
Is that it?
I mean, it's more complicated than that. You know, it'd take me forever to get into every little detail. Once I've finished, you can read it.
Fine. Well, come on. Let's go. What's wrong?
I'm lost for words.
Well, what time did you get up?
About 2 hours ago.
Well, no wonder you're lost for words. You need more sleep.
It's not the sleep, it's me. If I was a good writer, I'd be able to write freely with no problems. I mean, maybe I'm just wasting my time with a novel that's going nowhere.
You just need to believe in yourself, Erin. You are a good writer. Some of the stuff I've read is amazing.
Yeah, but no one's going to want to publish my stories.
I'd publish them, Erin. Not just because you're my boyfriend, but because they're worth publishing. Ever since you were a boy, you wanted to have a book. And that day will come. You just need to have faith.
You're so inspirational, Leola.
Oh, shut up. Anyway, I'm opening the cafe this morning and I'm late. Happy writing. Is that what the table looks like without all those papers on it?
Special. Gave me a reason to clear the table.
Look, I'm sorry to sour the mood, but that overdue rental bill, it's been sitting there for a while. We should probably pay it.
Look, I'm a little short for cash. Would you mind getting it just this time?
Fine, but I'm not bringing in a lot of money either. Being a waitress doesn't earn a lot.
Yeah, just riding all day with no job, give a lot either.
Well, maybe you could think about getting a small job on the side, like I have. Being a writer's risky. You don't know when your book's gonna get published.
When my book's gonna get published? This morning you were saying how good things are gonna come for me. Now you're saying I have to get a job because I can't rely on my novels?
Erin, that's not what I meant. It's just that in times like these, when we keep paying these overdue bills, you know, having a job on the side, it just might make life a little bit normal instead of living on a fine thread the whole time.
Look, let me finish this book, all right? And then I'll see what I can do. Happy?
Tell her I work where I want to work, but she doesn't understand the mere fact of that.
She tells me to try and I work under other conditions, but to put it simply, other conditions doesn't suit me. Her mindless self goes on, throwing pointless suggestions that do not help me, but only hinder my performance. She supports me at one point, but then slaps me in the face not long after. Yes, the lack of money is pulling us apart, but when something pulls you apart, love is the only force that will bind us back together.
Not a reality check on how my career might work?
What are you doing?
What are you writing about?
I told you.
Yeah, well, maybe not enough.
What did you read?
You think you can write real life stories into some low level book?
Look, Leola, that's not what it looks like.
It's okay, exactly what it looks like. How dare you? Get out of my way!
Thank you. so sorry. Yeah, how can I help you?